Our forward to reverse lunges, or sometimes referred to as our forward backward lunges, are a great strength and stability move for all the muscles of those legs. So for those quads, hamstrings, glutes, calves, all of those stabilizer muscles in the knees and the ankles as well. You can use a set of dumbbells like I showed in that demonstration, or you can use one dumbbell against the chest, or you can just start with body weight. It is completely up to you. You should be very familiar with a normal forward lunge and a normal reverse lunge before performing this exercise. If you're not, I encourage you to go watch our forward lunge demonstration video and our reverse lunge demonstration video prior to performing this so you know the basics of those exercises before we are combining them. So, a forward to reverse lunge or a forward backward lunge, we're going to be staying on that same leg, so that one leg, and we're going to be going into that forward lunge, right into that reverse lunge, back and forth. So make sure that you're focusing on your stepping, how far out you're stepping. Like I said, you should watch that forward lunge and that reverse lunge video because it dives a little more in depth to how far apart your feet should be. But the main gist of it is we're stepping forward, stopping that momentum, dropping straight down to where those knees are about at a 90 degree bend front and back. So we're not way up here, we're not way out here, we're about at that 90. We're gonna keep that foot flat on the floor as we drive out that whole foot. And then we're gonna go right back into that reverse lunge. Again, stepping back, dropping straight down to where we are about again at a 90. And we're going back and forth between those two movements. You can start off by setting your foot down in between those two movements, especially if you struggle with your balance and stability. What that looks like is going into a forward lunge, coming back to center, that foot sets down to kind of stabilize, stepping back into that lunge, forward, that foot sets down to stabilize. Once you get comfortable with that movement, to add a little bit more challenge in there as far as your balance goes, try not to set the foot down in between those two movements. So try to go into that forward lunge, lift that right foot up, keep it off the ground as you step back. And then the same thing going forward, keep it off the ground as you step forward. And you're going back and forth, transitioning between the two without setting that foot down. That's gonna focus a little bit more on our stability in our ankle and our knee for this exercise. Most common mistakes made, number one by far, not being comfortable with those two movements individually before combining them together. And what that looks like is, it looks like spacing for the feet is all over the place. I'll see people step out here, they'll won't step far enough, and then the knee's coming way out over the toe, and then they may step back way too far, and they're getting too much of a stretch in the hip. So make sure that you're comfortable with these movements, and that you're comfortable with finding a good distance every time you step out before performing this exercise. Another big thing to remember, make sure you keep your posture on this exercise. We are keeping that torso upright. We're not hinging on over, falling forward over that front leg. Same thing when we step back. We're not hinging on over, falling forward over the other leg. We're keeping that torso upright, and we're doing this to divide the weight of the body in between the two legs instead of always putting it on that front leg in each of those movements. So slow it down, start body weight, focus on your stability and your balance, and then progress up to where you're holding a weight at the chest or at your sides, and you're challenging your muscles a little bit more.